the way you convey information is as important as the information itself. Having built your outline, how do you take that and design your slides?
When you're thinking about your slide design, the most important concept by far is clarity. If somebody is confused looking at your slide, it doesn't matter what's on it, you're losing the impact you can have.
You have to think about the fonts you're using. You have to think about the size of the font you're using, the colors.
Depending on the room size, there could be people really far back, and it can be very hard to see complicated data figures and small font and less contrasting colors.
You should never use text blocks. Don't go and grab a screenshot of your favorite paragraph from a book and put it on your slide. If you really need to put that kind of information on your slides, make sure you use like very short sentences, maybe two or three bullet points, very short bullet points maximum.
The best slides are ones where there is a single image or set of images that are very related, preferably one or two pieces of data at the most, and that anything that is on the slide is relevant to your message.
Being very strategic about what your titles are can enable you to use up less space on the slide with other text, and it can really help you make sure that your audience is following along. I could choose to have a slide for which the title is simply cancer metabolism, or I could have a slide for which the title is cancer metabolism is altered in nearly 100% of tumors. The title can help your audience follow along with your conclusions or the main points that you're making.
When we design figures for papers, you know, there's a very different goal there and a very different venue than designing figures for a presentation. What are the minimum things that I can get away with that will convey my data in a way that my audience can see and understand visually pretty quickly? So if you're trying to show specific data points on a graph, for example, you can slowly animate those in. You could use circles or arrows, you know, or any other kind of figures or colors.
Start with the simplest version of it and then build on the complexity. And thinking about maps, you might see like the track of an animal. Start with just that, and then you might build on a layer that shows what the forest structure might look like. And then after that, you build on a new layer that might identify where some of the fruit trees are. If you were to start with that last image that has the track, it has the forest structure, it has the locations of fruit trees, like that's a lot to take in all at once. But if you've built it step by step, then people can see the initial image and then they can move on and see the more complex version, understand that and move on.
If you do field work, like maybe you're studying animal behavior or you're studying some kind of sound that an animal makes, I think it's really valuable to have audio or video really illustrating that.
I have learned to use Illustrator and Photoshop from online tutorials, but these are definitely not the only softwares that are available out there. You can build your slides or your figures in PowerPoint or in Keynote or in any other open source software you can find online.
There's a world of different colors and font styles that you can download. Just Google, oh, formal PowerPoint presentation template or fun PowerPoint presentation template. You can import that into your PowerPoint slide and use that as your format for putting together your presentation. And you'd be surprised how much a color change, a font change will affect how your message gets across.
When using multimedia, make sure that you have the rights and to mention the copyright holders at the bottom of your slide.
For published data, if it's open access, you can use that data as long as you cite. When it's not open source, sometimes you will need to request access.
It is important to acknowledge the work of other people.
I've seen talks where if someone really worked on an aspect of a project or did a specific experiment, that individual is acknowledged within the slide in which the speaker's talking about that.
And then I've also seen where people do it very nicely at the end, where they really highlight the different groups of people who did different things.
Your slides are the visual aid for what you're saying. Make sure that everything that you put on your slide helps the audience understand what you're trying to convey in a very accessible and clear way.